Anachari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Jaya Gopi Jana Vallabha Giri Varadari. Jaya Gopi Jana Vallabha Giri Varadari. Yashoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana. 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 Jamuna Tira Vanachari. Jamuna Tira Vanachari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Jaya Om Vishnupada Paramahamsa Parivijika Acharya Stotra Stotra Sata Shishi. Esi Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki. ISKCON Founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada Ki. Jaya Om Vishnupada Paramahamsa Parivijika Acharya Stotra Stotra Sata Shishi. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj Srila Prabhupada Ki. Ananta Koti Vaishnavanda Ki. Namacharya Sri Haridas Thakur ki Prem Shekau Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaura Bhaktavandaki. All glories to assembled devotees. All glories to assembled devotees. All glories to assembled devotees. All glories, all glories, all glories to Sri Guru and Gauranga. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskrityam Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Tato Jayam Udirahe Nashta Prayeshu Abhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavate Uttama Sloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naistiki Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devaki Nandanaya cha Nanda Gopa Kumaraya Govindaya Namo Namaha. Hare Krishna. We are taking this sloka from Canto 11, Chapter 26, Text 29. Taye Shanavanti Gayanti. He Anumodanti Chadrata. Mat Parasraddha Dhanascha Bhaktim Vindanti Te Mai Taye Shanavanti Gayanti Hai Anuman Anumodanti Chadrata Mata paraha siddha danascha Bhaktim vindanti te mai Taye shrinavanti gayanti He anumodanti chadrata Mata paraha siddha danascha Bhaktim vindanti te mai Taye shrinavanti gayanti Ve anumodanti chadrata Matpara Siddha Dhanascha Bhaktim Vindanti Te Mai Modanti Chadrita Matpara Siddhantamascha Bhaktim vindanti te mai Taye shrinavanti gayanti Anumodanti chadrata Matpada shraddha danascha Bhaktim vindanti te mai Mataji Taye shrinavanti gayanti Ye anumodanti chadrata Mata parasraddha danascha Bhaktim vindanti te mai Taha Those topics Ye persons Shananti, Shanavanti, hear, Gayanti, chant. He, indeed, Anumodanti, take to heart, Cha, and Adrata, with respect, Matparaha, dedicated to me, Siddhadhanaha, Faithful, cha, and bhaktim, devotional service, vindanti, achieve, te, that, mai, for me. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami's disciples. Translation, whoever hears, chants respectfully, take to heart these topics about me, becomes faithfully dedicated to me and thus achieves my devotional service. Please repeat. Whoever hears, chants, and respectfully takes to heart these topics about me, becomes faithfully dedicated to me, and thus achieves my devotional service. Purport. One who hears from advanced devotees of Lord Krishna can be saved from the ocean of material existence. When one obeys the order of bona fide spiritual master, the polluted working of the mind are checked. One sees things in the new spiritual light, and there blossoms the propensity for selfless loving service to the Lord, which gives the fruit of the love of Godhead. Om Jnananti Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshuru Militamena Tasmay Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Mano Bhishtam Stapidam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavamcha Shri Rupam Sagrajata Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Pada Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhanvitamsha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vushabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpataru Vyascha Kripa Sindhu Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna, with the mercy of the Vaishnavas, I could try to take this shloka and I needed all the blessing from all of you. Hare Krishna. So, it's a beautiful shloka. Whoever hears and chants respectfully takes to heart these topics about me, Lord's subject, becomes faithfully dedicated to me and thus achieves my devotional service. So here, important is given for hearing and chanting. It's most important. And most important subject for we Vaishnavas. It's a regular, our duty. And the point is that hears and chants respectfully. Takes to heart. It's an absorption. Take it to heart, not hearing casually. These topics about me becomes faithfully dedicated to me and thus achieves my devotional service. Then only we can achieve, the person can achieve the devotional service. And even in the purport, very nicely given, one who hears from advanced devotees of Lord Krishna can be saved from the ocean of material existence. When one obeys the order of bona fide spiritual master, the polluted workings of the mind are checked. Very nicely the purport explained. One sees things in a new spiritual light, and therefore there the blossoms the propensity for selfless loving service to the Lord, which gives the fruit of love of Godhead. The very three factors explained here, a person should hear from the advanced devotee of Lord Krishna. Second thing is, with that he can be saved from the ocean of material existence. Actually, Srila Prabhupada says, material existence, material nature is the really quite enemy for Krishna consciousness. It's enemy. So, somehow or other, you have to get rid of this material fact. And next, when one obeys the order of the bona fide spiritual master, the polluted working of the mind are checked. See, this is most important, that we have to hear from the spiritual master, bona fide spiritual master. The polluted working of mind is checked. One sees things in new spiritual light. Automatically gets a new spiritual light. And that blossoms the propensity for selfless loving service to the Lord, which gives the fruit of love of Godhead. So beautifully they mentioned. Ultimately, we have to get the love of God. Ultimately, pure love of God. Actually, this particular part, subject is from Aila Gita. There, Krishna is explaining to Uddhava. He's explaining because it is, you know, it connected from Pururava's realization after association with Urvashi. The subject comes from there. And you know what is the main subject? How to get rid of the sex desire. Very important subject. Also today, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur's appearance day. So both the things we try to discuss today in short time, in briefly. So, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, what to say about him? He was the spiritual master of Srila Prabhupada. And first meeting with Prabhupada was in 1922. He was a college boy, Prabhupada and Narendra Mulik, both the friends, they go to Ultadanga Road, Calcutta. One terrace, one sadhu was sitting, that was Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Narendra Mulik was saying, come, we can go and meet that sadhu. But Prabhupada was not that much interested. He said, nowadays I don't trust these sadhus. They are so many fakes. No. So, no, he is not like that sadhu. So, he takes it, the story all of you know. When both of them went to that terrace, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur was sitting. As the Vaishnava practice, they both give dandavat obeisances. Before they got up, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur gave an instruction. You, the young boys, educated boys, you should take this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Krishna conscious to the Western country and preach in English language. This was the instruction. You can ask them to little reduce their volume. So you take this Krishna conscious which was given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and go to the Western country and speak in English language. Prabhupada was leader that time. He was a leader of the college boys and all. And he said he was with the Gandhi movement. And he said, Swamiji, who is going to listen us? We are under the slavery of British. Who are going to listen us? We wanted independent. Nobody will listen us. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur gives a beautiful answer. You are talking about independent of your body or independent of your soul. You may be under British or you are earlier with Mughals. You may get independent also, independence. But for spiritual life, there is no connection of whatever the material change. It is a duty of Indian who has got the treasure of Vedic culture, he should go and distribute it to the whole world. Then Prabhupada was silently watching because he was thinking, once India gets independence, we are free. Like here I could see a person who is talking about go to the whole world, give them this absolute truth and uplift them. This is your job. Whole world, and this one person is talking about the whole world. I was thinking it is just India to be get liberated. We have this always Maharashtra Sangha, Karnataka Sangha, Punjab Sangha. We have some, our Sangha gets freedom, we are all perfect. But this was not like that. And Prabhupada was just thinking inside. One person is that who is thinking about giving this absolute truth of Krishna consciousness to the whole universe, whole world. And this is first time I saw. So we have to broad enough in spiritual life to attain Krishna's love. So then he said, this time I defeated with one person. I never defeated anywhere in argument. This time I have defeated, but I consider him, I take him in my heart. He is my spiritual master. He accepts him. Prabhupada accepts him as a spiritual master. See the power of a spiritual master, because by sadhu sangha, it becomes so wonderfully, we can see here. And Srila Prabhupada, he was having business. First meeting was in 1922. And then he gets a message that there was some Vrajamandal Parikram for 1 month. All were going, 1933 something, that time. So they said, are you going to come to our Vrajamandal Parikram? He said, I can't come for that because I have 1 month I can't come. But I'll try to spare for a few days, last days. So Prabhupada could go last days, about couple of days were there. It was at Kochi. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur was giving the class. That was the ending, you know. People were on the different mood. When Yatra gets you know, in the mood of over, people gets for going for purchase and going here and there. So people were in scattered mood. And Prabhupada said, I came first time. I never listened to my spiritual master. Let me sit. Some Kshirodakshay Vishnu there, you can go there, you can hear. There is good choice were there. But Prabhupada said, no, I have to sit and hear. So he sat, it was the first class he was hearing from Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And it was around 3 hours. And Prabhupada said it was somewhere entering in my inside, others I could not understand anything. Most of the things I could not understand. But I couldn't get up from there because there was no chance to hear my spiritual master. That is hearing. Today's sloka, hearing is most important. Shravanam, that was hearing. So he sat there up to three hours. Then finally, Guru Maharaj left. He had to go next day for Dhaka. So Prabhupada came from there. Then after a few days, those people from that Allahabad, Prabhupada was there in Allahabad, and they said, you know, Swamiji, our Guru Maharaj is going to come to Allahabad. He wanted to give initiation also. Srila Prabhupada was asking, am I an eligible person to take initiation? They said, yes, yes, definitely. Abhay Babu, you will be definitely going to get. We will introduce you. So, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur had come. That time all the least was there and the people had come whom they are going to recommend. So, all the name had come. Then, Abhay Charan Day, the name had come. So, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur saw him. And they were introducing Gurudev. This is a person very nicely playing mridanga. He is giving some good chant. This also donation. He's a good singer. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur said, yeah, good. But he's a good listener. He never gets up from the class. Definitely I will give him the initiation. So this is the qualification we have to understand. Sitting on the class, you know, tirelessly and listening and observing and following. He's practicing. These are the things. So he gave importance there. And you know, the main thing, he got both the initiation, Srila Prabhupada, when he got the initiation, Vaishnava initiation as well as Brahman initiation also he got, Prabhupada. And this training they gave by Bhakti Vinod Thakur, he made a training. Srimad Bhagavatam in the morning, evening Bhagavad Gita. This training was there for the Vaishnavas. So this training they are following as per parampara. Bhakti Vinod Thakur and Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, they are following that. And the Bhakti Vinod Thakur used to give this class at Jagannath Puri. There was a courtyard at Mahalakshmi temple. One day what happened was, in that, when the class was going on, Bhakti Vinod Thakur's, most of the people were there, but to that temple, that area, the king came with his procession. Because these people were very, very strict and really honoring and nicely respecting the classes, all the person, even audience and the preachers. So when that king arrived there, there was a big band and some orchestra, big things have come, you know, big music and all. And he was giving silence class, so immediately Bhakti Vinod Thakur is gone to the king. He asked, who is the king here? Whether you are the king or Jagannath is the king? He said, Jagannath is the king. So what right you got to disturb about hearing Jagannath? Then king asked forgiveness and he left the place. So these were the people who the parampara they have come. The same way our his son has got the same thing, same type of the importance for the class and absorption. Today's shloka that gives that same absorption, hearing and chanting. That removes all your anarthas, dirt out of your heart. That is only a way that takes out anarthas out from your heart. And this was a brief introduction of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Actually, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, he uplifted our Gaudiya Vaishnava Parampara, and he wanted some good strength and some person to uplift this. So he was praying to Jagannath Puri, Vimla Devi, I wanted some ray which can uplift this Krishna consciousness everywhere. He was praying very seriously, Bhakti Vinod Thakur. And but because of that ray which comes as Vimla Prasad, that Giti gives a name, that is Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. He takes birth in 6th of February, 1874. And he was with the association of his father, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, very sincerely. In childhood only, he was very active. Quickly, he was mastered all of the scriptures, especially Vedas, and even Bhagavad Gita. He was totally memorized, very very young age, and he's released father's philosophical works, and he was the knower of encyclopedia of vast knowledge, very wonderfully, from childhood onwards. Before preaching, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he he was knowing the importance of chanting the holy name. So once he takes anything, he used to take it very seriously. That's why he's called Simha Guru. When he was a very small child, about 4 years, he was not offered the mango to Lord, and father asked him, did you offer the mango? He said, sorry, I couldn't offer. And immediately he took a oath. In my entire life, I will never touch mango. I will never eat mango. Such a way in the beginning stage. Same way, before preaching, before going for the full-fledged preaching, for 9.5 years, he chanted 3 lakhs name in Chandrasekhar Bhavan before doing that. With fully equipped way, he started his preaching after getting that spiritual potency as well as qualification. He was knowing this is the qualification needed. And both of them, Bhakti Vinod Thakur and Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, father and son, they excavated the Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's birthplace, Yoga Pita. That was one of the things, because there was a lot of, practically people never wanted to show this place, but these people genuinely found it, and then they installed Gaudiya Math temple there, and the especially the thing is that to give this to people, give this Krishna consciousness to people, he was very busy with that. And he built about 64 Gaudiya Mutts, which was giving the philosophy of Krishna consciousness that time. And his one weapon, that was Brahat Mridanga, printing all those things and giving that every time and publishing. So all the time they were in that printing press, they used to publish the Bhagavad Gita, Chaitanya Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Mangala, Srimad Bhagavatam, and Prema Bhakti Chandrika, and finally very favorite book of Chaitanya Charitamrita. These were all printing. These were all the books. That's why, and then by these, you can attain, how to attain the pure love of God by understanding these books. Pure love of God. That's why the worshipping Lord of Gandharvika Giridhari, Radha Krishna, the love of Krishna is important. So these all scriptures, they'll help the person to progress in Krishna consciousness. There were many success in India, but greatest contribution is Srila Prabhupada. Because that instruction, he took it initially. And then after that, again, 1934, again he asked, what is the instruction for me? He got the same answer. You are the qualified person. Go and preach this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's gospel in English language. So he took it very seriously. 1922, he took it. And he could fulfill it by the mercy of our Sumati Murarji, free ticket. In 1965, he could travel. And it took about 43 years to prepare. Prabhupada just prepared it very nicely before going. And not only that, he preached it all over the world, because his instruction of his spiritual master was all over the world. You have to go it all over the world. That was Prabhupada. And whoever speaks about, whenever he speaks about his spiritual master, he was saying, what to speak about Baba, my spiritual master? He was a Vaikuntha man. So highly grateful Srila Prabhupada had. Anything is successful, Prabhupada used to say, this is because of my spiritual master's mercy and Krishna's mercy. I never deserve any credit. I am just a postman peon, very humble. This is the particular thing. When we can get Krishna conscious humbly, that Prabhupada is giving one good example. Because after studying all those things, they could get a mastery. Even here, in the last word, in purport is given that one sees things in a new spiritual light and there blossoms the propensity for the selfless loving service to the Lord. Selfless loving service to the Lord. That is blossoming. Fully blossoming, not halfway. Pura bhakti khil jata hai. Devotional service for so many years of Krishna consciousness. No doubt, nothing, fully surrendered. Then they like get a love of God. I'll give example. You all know about it. Prabhupada gives it very, we heard also so many times. Prabhupada gives it very important way. What happened is, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is visited Sri Rangakshetra, that time, you know, there was one illiterate Brahmana. He was reading Bhagavad Gita. And he was illiterate. He was just holding and turning pages and all were teasing, joking with him, you know. They were not allowing him to read also, you know, other temple people, Brahmanas and all. But he was daily regular in reading. We have heard about it. But why I wanted to tell you, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you know, it is a very huge temple. Or Rangakshetra is a huge temple. This person in one corner, he was reading. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came there and he was asking, my dear boy, what you are doing it? What are you doing? He said, just seeing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he said, this person is seriously asking me. He is not come for joking or something or amusement. He said, I actually wanted to, I am reading Bhagavad Gita. My spiritual master asked me to read Bhagavad Gita. And that's why I am reading it. I am illiterate. I don't know anything. Because of the order of my spiritual master, I am reading. I am trying to read that Bhagavad Gita, nothing else. I don't understand anything. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked, why there is tears on your, why you are crying? Tears I could see. Why you are crying? That time that Brahmana says, when I see this book, Supreme Personality of God and Lord Krishna, he is taken such a menial job of a driver, a sarathi. He is a Supreme Personality of God. Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayak. He has got created Koti Koti Brahmanda Nayak. He is the owner of that. He is just taking the menial service of driver, sarathi. We heard it earlier also. This I can't tolerate. Because Lord has taken as a bhakta vasala, so menial job, very lowest position. This I can't tolerate it. What a way Lord has taken the position. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu felt it. He embraced him. You understood Bhagavad Gita. You understood Bhagavad Gita. Srila Prabhupada says, one who loves Krishna, he can only understand Bhagavad Gita. One who loves Krishna, there is no other qualification needed. PhD is not needed. Your entire world, you are loving Krishna alone. This was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given us. Krishna is your mother. Krishna is your father. Krishna is your wealth. Don't forget Krishna. 24 hours you should love Krishna. That is Krishna consciousness. PhD wala or big, you know, scholars, no surety. They may, Prabhupada said, they may change it any time. They may do anything. But this person who is having a humble and he's not knowing anything, thinking himself disqualified, such people, they'll have a mercy. Their heart is purified and they get pure Krishna consciousness. And Prabhupada gives very important stress on that. Because even we heard so many times that one Brahmana was there, he was illiterate, he was reading. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went there to show us even an illiterate person is eligible for getting Krishna consciousness very fast. And you got Krishna consciousness. Sarvopadi vinirmuktam, tatparatvena nirmalam, rishikena rishikesha sevanam bhakti rutam. All upadis have got no value. You have to make nirmala first. And what you have to do? Rishike. Your senses to be used rishikesha. The owner of the senses is rishikesha, Krishna. Put all energy, serve that rishikesha. That is important. Those senses to be purified. So here, even in this case, the humility. Otherwise, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would have neglected him. But this is the preaching. By his practical thing, we understand it. For understanding Krishna consciousness, no big literature or PhD is needed. This same thing we can understand with the Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. He was encyclopedia in all philosophy, everything. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur, his father said, you should go and take initiation from Gaur Kishore Das Babaji. He was illiterate. So he goes over there, and when he meets Bhakti Gaurakishwadas, Babaji was just not looking at him, neglecting him. And he was thinking, I don't think I can take initiation from him. And Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati was writing, because he no communication, he's neglecting me. And then he comes back to his father and says, I don't think I can take initiation from Gaurakishwadas Babaji. His father says, if you want to live, if you wanted to live in spiritual life, go and beg and take from him only, Gaurakishwadas Babaji. So then he goes there and he was crying. And finally with the association he understands that whatever this, your designation, your encyclopedia, your philosophy, all this qualification will never help you for getting Krishna's love. Then finally, Gaurakishwadas Babaji gives him initiation. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, no match at all. No? He's such a qualified, and this is a person is Anguta Chap, illiterate. So Prabhupada wanted to give more emphasize that even any upadhis you have, you cannot get the spiritual progress. And in material contamination, only Prabhupada was the person. Sense enjoyment, sense gratification, you will fall in miserable condition. You will end it in miserable condition. You have come here self-realization. Not for sense gratification. Prabhupada was only the acharya highlighted. Don't go for this. Many of the people are that. Prabhupada said, no sense gratification. Go for self-realization. You are the spirit soul. So this brahmanas thing, we know what Prabhupada was saying? Krishna conscious is important. This Krishna conscious is a food for the soul. So once you practice properly in this Krishna consciousness, you know ultimate, whoever he may be, whoever the person may be, you know what is ultimate? One day will come, your brain will not stopping working, your heartbeat will be reducing, and your lung is not going to function. Gradually, you are on the path of leaving this body, soul will leave the body. So Prabhupada said, that time, this Krishna conscious, Krishna's name will come to uplift you because you have practiced. Krishna's mercy is there. Soul is purified. Then he gives, you know, these Vraja Gopis, they were also not having highly qualified, no fashion, illiterate, but they had a love for Krishna. Same way, love for Krishna, that is important. Soul is, have got love for Krishna. That's why 24 hours it is busy with loving Krishna. And this stage which is there of loving Krishna, that will uplift, and that is the blossoming Krishna consciousness. And that with that love, you will go back home, back to Godhead. That is the way, that is the process. Chanting, kirtan, shravana, kirtana. This will do that. So, how you can reduce your particularly, Prabhupada's word I'll say, because Prabhupada is very serious about sexual desire to reduce. So I'll just, in his word I'll read. Srila Prabhupada, there was a question. It was morning walk in May 14th, 1975, Perth, Australia. Devotee, Srila Prabhupada, how can the position be reconciled if in Krishna consciousness one of the two, husband and wife, wants to enjoy sense gratification but the other does not? Should there be a separation then? Prabhupada, no. They should be trained up. Sense enjoyment means not advanced in Krishna consciousness. As soon as one is advancing in Krishna consciousness, his sense enjoyment spirit will be reduced. And that is the test. The test is how you are advancing in Krishna consciousness is the proportionate diminishing the sense enjoyment. When you are advancing, there will be sense enjoyment is diminishing, proportionate it is. Sense enjoyment. That is the test. Just like cure of the disease means diminishing the fever, temperature, this is the test. The disease is cured. And this is one of the very interesting. What if the fever is not being diminished? The question. Even doing after that, if it is not diminished, the Prabhupada gives very good answer. Then he should try higher dose. He should go for more dose. Chant Krishna mantra, Hare Krishna mantra, instead of 16 rounds, increase it. Go for 64 rounds. That is the way. 16 rounds is the minimum. It's passing mark. It's the minimum. Not distinct. Big, not 100%. Otherwise, Haridas Thakur was chanting 3 lakh names, so you have to increase. That is the only remedy. If one has to determination, he will make progress without any trouble. Here the determination is very important. Determination of taking, getting pure love of God. That is the it requires determination. We have to follow all the principle. That's why Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur was Siva Guru. No compromising of anything. And that determination is needed. Even that's why Srila Prabhupada used to say that the determination is very difficult. That determination, I must have Krishna consciousness fully. This is the determination. I should have fully disturbed, fully blossom. No, nothing is less. Fully blossomed Krishna consciousness. Nothing is less. Pure, pure love. Pure love. Krishna conscious love. Nothing is contaminated. Nothing can put us away from that. Unflinching faith. Krishna is absolute truth. 24 hours. Absolute truth. Krishna is absolute truth. Whatever he said is perfect. So Prabhupada says, you have to be like Arjuna. Because initially Arjuna was thinking Krishna was my friend. Finally he took the advice, I take you as I consider you as my guru. Please, please show me the way. And Bhagavad Gita, when we take it, we have to be like Arjuna's consciousness. You can progress. At last, after 10th chapter, Krishna says, whatever I have given is mine. Your hand itself is mine. How could you keep this Gandiva down? How could you decide that you are not going to fight? That your hand is my hand. You are deciding that you are not going to fight? You have to serve me with my hand. How could you decide? You have to please me. Samsiddhir Haritoshanam. So Arjuna says, Karishte Vachanam Tava. I was in illusion. Now I will definitely follow your point. I will definitely do it. Whatever you say. This is the instruction what all of us should take it. To please Krishna. We have to be like Arjuna. Because we are in illusion. But the day will come. We get matured. And Krishna conscious is our final requirement. And that requirement, this word is given very, very wonderfully practical. That translation. That whoever hears, chants respectfully, takes to heart, absorption, takes to heart. These topics about me, becomes faithfully dedicated to me and thus achieves my devotional service. Then we attain pure love of God, pure love of God, pure love of Krishna. Philosophically a bit hard, but you have to do it ultimately. There is no other way. Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama eva kevalam, kalau naaste eva, naaste eva, naaste eva gati ranyata. There is no other way, there is no other way, there is no other way. You have to go for chanting and hearing. This is a wonderful sloka, which I was very happy to hear because nothing I have to add in this. Because chant and hear, you will become perfect and you absorb in it. And it is a process. Krishna will make it purified because that these are all the transcendental subject. You will get whatever required with best way we attain and we get love of God. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Grantharaj Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Srila Prabhupada ki. Hare Krishna.